Welcome back, Colonels. Now that you've mapped your research topic to develop research questions, identified and brainstormed keywords, and created your search statement, it's finally time to explore databases and find those academic sources you'll need to support your research project. In this tutorial, we will learn the basics of navigating a library database, how to use search statements in the database, and how to refine our original searches. Let's get started. Remember, we had a research question about how social media impacted the mental health of teenagers. This is our first search statement. Now, we'll go to the EKU Libraries homepage at library.eku.edu. We're going to start at the search box near the top of the main library homepage and select the link for databases. This is the landing page for the hundreds of databases that EKU Libraries makes available to you. These databases are arranged alphabetically, but you can also browse them by the subject area of your topic. If you aren't sure what subject area your topic would fit into, think about who would research and write about your topic and the field or discipline in which they would work. For example, people working in the psychology field write about topics related to mental health. So I want to look at some psychology-focused databases. So let's click on the All Subjects drop-down and choose Psychology. This brings up a list of databases that are the best bets for psychology. Let's take a quick look at those. You'll notice in the box toward the top, there are a few that stand out, such as Psych Articles and Psych Info. So let's remember that for later. However, for today's search, we want to start with Academic Search Ultimate because it is a general, multidisciplinary database, which means it should have something for everyone, regardless of the discipline or subject of their topic. There's a link for it here on the left in the Featured Databases column. This is the Advanced Search screen in Academic Search Ultimate. Notice that I have three search boxes, and each box is already connected by the Boolean operator and that we learned about in the last module. I like this because it helps me make better use of my search statement. For example, I can keep each of the unique concepts from the original research question, those words between the ands in my search statement, in its own search box, like this. Social media in the first box, and mental health in the second box, and teenagers in the third box. I only have three unique concepts, so this works for me. If you have more than three, you could add more boxes using this Add Fields link. Now, remember how I added synonyms for social media and teenagers to my search statement? I can add those synonyms now by typing the word or and then the synonyms in the relevant box. I'll add or social networking to the first box with social media, and then I'll add or youth or adolescence to the third box with teenagers. You'll probably notice that the database is offering suggestions in each search box based on what I am typing. While these can sometimes be useful, I don't want to immediately accept those suggestions. However, I might write them down for later use, especially if I don't already have them in my keyword brainstorm table. Now let's click on the search button and see what our first search statement will give us. One of the first things I notice is that my keywords are still here at the top, but they have been combined into one search box. Notice that the keywords that we had in each of the previous search boxes are now connected inside parentheses. This is very helpful to visualize the search terms that we are currently using, and you can modify your search using this box. Next, I notice that I'm currently seeing the first 10 results out of over 1,000 results. I feel good about that because it shows that a lot of people are researching and writing about social media and the mental health of teenagers. And if I skim the results, the titles suggest many of the results are relevant to my original research question. For example, the first article is about social networking, depression, and anxiety in adolescence. Let's scroll a little further. I see a couple more that are useful. For example, this article discusses the role of social networks and its addictive behavior with psychosocial health. And this article explores the role of social media and eating disorders in adolescence. I'm going to scroll back up because I'm reminded that there are over 1,000 results here, and that's a bit too much for this assignment and a little too much for me to go through. So let's think about how we might focus and narrow our search statement to get fewer but perhaps more relevant results. One way is to return to our keyword brainstorm table. For social media, we brainstormed several types of social media platforms. We could replace both social media and social networking in our search statement with one or more of these specific platforms. Since fewer articles are likely to be written on specific social media platforms than on the idea of social media or social networking at the broad level, we'll likely get fewer results if we focus in on specific platforms. And to be honest, I'm actually most interested in social media platforms that are very visual in nature, like TikTok, YouTube, and Instagram. So let's go back to our search. While you can modify your search using the bar at the top of the page, I prefer to go back into the advanced search so that I have my three separate search boxes again. So now let's replace social media or social networking with TikTok or YouTube or Instagram. While I know that TikTok, Instagram, and YouTube aren't synonyms for each other, they're actually different social media platforms, using or works here because they really mean the same thing in the context of my research assignment. I'm just interested in visual social media platforms, mental health, and teenagers. So let's click search and see how our results might change. That took us down to 153 results, which seems much more manageable. And if I skim these results, I'm seeing some articles that are a little more focused. Here's an article about TikTok, another about TikTok, an article about Instagram, and another about TikTok. We could stop here, but we might be missing out on some great articles. Remember earlier in this tutorial when I mentioned that EKU Libraries subscribes to hundreds of databases and that we were going to use Academic Search Ultimate because it is general and multidisciplinary? Another great reason to start with Academic Search Ultimate is because it lets us search several of those other databases, most of which are discipline or subject specific, and we can search them at the same time as we search Academic Search Ultimate. To do that, we go to the top of the page and find this Searching Academic Search Ultimate link. Clicking that link gives us a pop-up that allows us to select multiple databases that we can search at the same time we're searching Academic Search Ultimate. Remember earlier when we looked at those best bet databases for psychology? Well, let's find those, APA Psych Articles and APA Psych Info. So I'm going to add those to our search. Sometimes the database title will give you a little clue that it will be relevant to your topic. So let's also add Psychology and Behavioral Sciences Collection, because that looks like it's going to be very appropriate for our topic. Once we've selected all the databases that we want to add to the search, click Select, and let's see how those update our search results. Okay, and so now we see that the link now says Searching, Academic Search Ultimate, and three more. So we know we've added those databases into our search. Let's skim these titles, and we see that the articles are still relevant and are pulling in those specific social media platforms, just like it was before, except now we have a few more to work with. Now that we've got a good group of articles to browse through, let's look at some of the useful features of this database platform. At the top of the page, under the search statement, I see this All Filters box. Clicking that box will open a menu on the right-hand side of the page that will allow us to add filters to our search. These make the search more specific, which will narrow and reduce the number of results I get back from a search. For example, if your instructor is requiring you to use only scholarly, peer-reviewed articles, you might want to select the peer-reviewed filter. If you would like to see articles that are really recent, you can use the publication date filter to modify the date range. Clicking on the title of an article will take me to a page that tells me a little bit more about the article and gives me some options for that article specifically. Let's take a look at one of these articles. Let's take a look at Vent Talk, Exploring the Mental Health Narrative on TikTok. When I click on the title, I get a page with information about that article. It includes the authors, the journal, and usually an abstract, which is basically a summary of the article that can help you know if reading this article will be relevant to your research. Back toward the top of the page, in the title box, I see this Access Options drop-down. Anytime you see PDF or online full text, those are options for opening this article and reading it immediately. While either option is just fine, the PDF can be a little more helpful because this is essentially a scan or picture of the article the way it appeared in the original journal, and will include helpful things like page numbers that can be good for in-text citations. So let's click the back arrow in the upper left corner to go back where we were. To save this article, you can either download it onto your device, email it to yourself, or copy the URL in the top address bar into an email or document so you can come back to this article. If I click on Cite, I get a pop-up in the middle of the page that includes several different citation styles, including some of the most common at EKU, such as APA, Chicago, and MLA. Use the Cite feature with caution, however, and always double-check this against a citation manual, the Excelsior Writing Lab, the OWL at Purdue, or another trusted citation site. Let's take a look at another example. When I try to access the article, Social Media's Mental Health Problem, I notice that I don't have the PDF or online full text options. Instead, I have Find Full Text. If I click on Find Full Text, I'll see my options for getting this article. Sometimes clicking on the Find Full Text link will lead us to the full text somewhere else online, but sometimes we won't have access to the article immediately. In those cases, you will see the message, Item not in our collection, request for free from EKU libraries. This message is a link that will take you to a Library Express request form. Library Express is a service that will get sources for you when we don't have them already, and it's free to you, so don't be afraid to use it. Now that you know how to take your search statement into a library database and find articles that will help you with your research, head back to the module for directions for your next assignment. If you need more help, check out our FAQs and tutorials, or consider scheduling a research consultation or chatting with a librarian online. Good luck and happy searching!